Jacques, oh Tom, 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 oh Paul, un Jacques, oh Tom.
Thank you. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the second edition of Cannabis Startup in Europe. Thank you for coming back, and thank you for coming for the first time. So, what's the goal of this meetup? First of all, is to learn about a specific topic dedicated to cannabis. So, every month we pick a topic, and we have a speaker talking about it. And then why it's also interesting to come is really to connect with smart people working into the industry and to create together some very nice projects around cannabis to build up the industry in Europe. So this month I'm going to talk about hemp, the secret crop that's taking over the world, and tell you in more details what are the possibility of products we can make today with hemp, as well as a bit of history. But to start by the basic, I will introduce you to what is hemp. Hemp has been used for thousands of years for the stalks. So what is the stalks? Is actually the plant where you can extract the fiber. So for thousands of years, hemp has been grown all over Europe for the stalks in this kind of field. So you don't have much flower, you don't have much leaf, but you have a very strong stalks. After, you have also the seeds, which have been more and more used in the past 20-30 years, particularly in the food, and the flowers, which is something kind of new, using the hemp flowers to get the compound from cannabis, from hemp, to get the cannabinoids. So what is defining hemp? Hemp is cannabis with less than 0.2% THC. So it's a kind of family of cannabis, just it doesn't contain THC, so you cannot get high with hemp. However, it contains also some other cannabinoids and compounds like terpene and flavonoids. And the most used of the cannabinoids in hemp today is the CBD. In the hemp strains you can legally cultivate today in Europe, you have up to 5 or 6% of CBD, which is very interesting to create CBD products. So, how I talked about that already, but so this is hemp. At the top you have the flowers as well as the seeds, and in the middle is the stalks. So to go in more details about how you can use the different parts of hemp, first of all you have the seeds, which have been used for a lot of times to create some hemp seeds oil, for example. So the hemp seeds oil, it's an oil you can use when you cook. It's not like an olive oil, it's not like a sesame oil, it's a hemp seeds oil, and you can actually buy this hemp seeds oil in very large shops today. So the seeds have been used mainly in three categories of products. The first one, and where is the most used, is the food. So you have a lot of seed oil, you have also a lot of protein made from the seeds. And actually, the seeds from hemp is one of the first sources of natural protein you can get. So it's very interesting for people which want to add more protein into their daily routine. For example, people doing some musculation. But still, a natural way, because protein, most of the time, is coming from animal source. And hemp is actually, hemp seeds is one of the first sources of natural protein. And then you have also all the food supplements using seeds as a superfood. A lot of people are really into this now. They buy some of seeds of hemp to add into their salad and to add into their meal. And why actually, maybe I should have started with this, because hemp seeds is actually also very big in omega-3 and omega-6. So it's very good to use it into your food. You have also a very big usage of hemp seeds on the industrial industry. So hemp seeds are used for fuel, hemp seeds are used to make some oil for painting, to make some different kind of products that big companies are using industrially. And the last part where hemp seeds is very used is for body care, for particularly cosmetic. Maybe some of you know the brand called The Body Shop, which is a very famous cosmetic brand. And they have a hemp cosmetic range of products, which actually is selling very well, and is based on hemp seeds. Because again, you have omega-3, omega-6, which is very good for the skin. So most of the cosmetics today, the cannabis cosmetic, actually are using hemp seed oil for the omega-3 and omega-6. Okay. All right, this order is better. Then something which has been more and more used the past few years is the hemp flowers. And the hemp flowers, as I told you, contains a lot of CBD. So the hemp farmers didn't use cannabinoids really before. They was growing for the fiber or for the seeds. Now the hemp farmers are growing also for the flower, because in the flower of hemp, you can have up to 5, 6, 7% of CBD. It will after depends on the strain you use, the hemp strain you're gonna use. Because some of them don't have CBD, some of them have a lot of CBD. And it will also depend on the environment, how you grow it. If you grow hemp in north of Europe, there is not a lot of sun, so you won't get a very high level of CBD or cannabinoids. However, if you grow it in south Spain, and if you give also some space to the hemp to get as much sun as possible, so if you optimize your cultivation for the flower, you can get 5, 6, 7% CBD. So actually hemp can be a very good source for cannabinoids. And why it's so great is also because it's totally legal to grow. So actually, thanks to hemp, you're able to extract some cannabinoids which can be used after for a very wide range of application. And where we focus the most today is CBD, which is the cannabinoids the most present into the hemp flowers. And CBD, I'm not going to talk in details about it today, but it's been more and more used for different kinds of products, including the medical well-being and body care products. So you have today some kind of products which are delivering CBD in different kind of formats, and that's what we do at Harmony, focusing on the deliverability of CBD that we extract from hemp. And the last thing very good with hemp is the stalk. And actually the stalk is what people have been using in hemp for thousands of years. So stalks include fibers and hearts. So sorry for my English accent. you understand what I mean. So for the fiber, actually, hemp has been used for thousands of years for the fiber. At some point, the fiber from hemp was the only one people was using, for example, to create ropes. So all the boats, like from 200-300 years ago, was actually made from hemp for the ropes and for the sail as well. So it's a very good material for textile, for industrial textile as well, for industrial farming. Today, a lot of people in industrial farms are using hemp for animal bedding. And the last aspect of stalks and the usage of stalks is for building materials. And this is something also growing very quickly. You have some people building house made from hemp, made from hempcrete. So a hempcrete is like a crete, and you just use them to create walls. And it's very good because it's a very good material for insulation and as well as for the fire properties. You have also actually more and more people using hemp to do even 3D printing. So 3D printing is using usually some synthetic fiber to create objects. And today there are some companies actually using hemp to create some 3D objects and hemp for 3D printers. So, now I explain you how you can use hemp in a very big variety of products. And maybe you're wondering why hemp is not more used, why all these products I just mentioned are not widely available, and you cannot find them into the shop next in your street. So there are different reasons to that. The first one, the biggest one, is the prohibition and the diabolization of cannabis. That's something you all know. Cannabis has been diabolized for almost 100 years by Americans, by the US. So that's something started in the 30s. Different reason of the prohibition and diabolization, wrong reason at this time. But cannabis suffered from a very heavy campaign of diabolization for different reasons, political reasons, racism and business reasons as well. And America has been actually putting some very strong law against cannabis in the US, and it ended up something totally crazy, but hemp has been totally banned from the US in the 70s. In the 70s, they created the Controlled Substance Act, which was a very big law to control most of the drugs, including cannabis. And in this act, they also banned hemp, even if they was growing hemp a lot, but they put everything into the same basket and they just banned it all. So actually, for 30, 40 years, you couldn't grow any hemp in the US. It was totally forbidden to grow and to import. Even if hemp in the US as well has been used on the industrial level to make some fiber, so some products totally different from marijuana that you smoke to get high. So it's one of the main reasons. And this has been leading to big companies being very afraid to work with hemp, because for their image, first of all, it's very dangerous for them, because big companies have a lot of clients. So if they start to use something which is close to cannabis, even if it's just hemp, their clients maybe will have a bad image. So for their image is bad, and as well as with the regulations, it's been very difficult to use hemp and to develop projects based on hemp, because the regulation is very strict. So you have to get some special license, and also it's very limiting. So it limits actually the possibility of investment in the long term. It was not clear, so it was not easy. And that's why actually most of big companies don't want or didn't want to touch hemp. Another reason why hemp has not been used much is in the beginning of in the 30s, 40s, the industry for fiber started to use some other plants which had cheaper production. So for example, the cotton in the 30s, there was an explosion of cotton, and cotton is cheaper to use, and also to make clothing and fiber and fabric, it was more easy to use than hemp. So it made hemp, the growth of hemp declining a bit, because the main perspective to build product with hemp at this time was fiber. And hemp with fiber from hemp, had a lot of competition with cotton as well as synthetic fiber. Also, because of the strong regulation, nobody was really doing investment in hemp. So they wasn't really creating some extraction facility for hemp, and they didn't really find some new ways to use hemp in outside of fiber. So today it's changing a bit, and that's why I will talk a bit about the hemp industry today. And first of all, the state of hemp acreage all over the world. So hemp is not cultivated in a very massive scale. Actually, hemp is really a very small portion of cultivation today in the world, and it's been fluctuating a lot. But what you can notice from this graph is that actually, here in Europe, we were the leading place to grow hemp. So we were the one growing most of the hemp all over the world. Today, you have also China, which is not here, which is growing a lot of hemp for fiber. But as you can see, actually, in the US, almost nobody is growing hemp because it's been illegal all this time. Now, for 2 or 3 years, they start to grow hemp again. So in 2015, actually, they got their first field of hemp in Colorado, but this for research and development. However, it's going to get super big very soon. Canada has been growing a lot of hemp, specializing on the seeds. And today, Canada is actually the biggest producer of hemp outside of China. So all that to say that in Europe, actually, we have a very strong experience about growing hemp. And for once, we are not late in the game about hemp in comparison to North America. So I believe we should use this experience to create some more and more products and more projects around hemp. And if we don't do it, the Americans will do it very soon. So it would be too bad to let them again a great industry. This is the potential of expansion of the hemp market just in the US. There is a firm doing some special forecasting, explaining, and why I put this slide, because you can see the different usage of hemp in the different category of products. And when you look at this, actually, you will notice that hemp will grow mostly, and the biggest segment is for the industrial applications. So hemp is a plant you can use for CBD, you can use for food, for supplements, for personal care, but actually that's really the industrial application which are taking most of the market. Today the market is still very small, but that's where it's supposed to go. And hemp is on this forecasting in a very big growth right now, so the demand for hemp is really growing year after year. This is for some forecasting only for the US again, but the growth is very, very big, and it's because also cannabis is more and more mainstream. So people are less and less afraid, have less cliché about hemp, because cannabis is more and more well known now, and it's not just about getting high, and people know it. There is also the medical aspect, the industrial usage. So that's very good to know, because now you have also more and more investments. So with the investment into the hemp industry, you have more and more companies doing some research and development to create new products and to expand the usage on hemp outside of fiber. Because as a fiber, hemp is great, but it's quite expensive to compete with cotton. So that's really good to see the market growing, more investments coming in, so we can find new usage, innovative usage based on hemp. So very short talk today. Thank you again, everyone, for coming in Harmony office. And I will let you now get back to your interesting discussion, as well as some very delicious hemp food that we prepared for you with love. So there is some nice tortilla, there is some nice cake based on hemp. So feel free to test it out. And let me know if you have any questions. Happy to discuss this in more details with you. Thank you.